طيب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. We'll start with the fiqh class first, and then we go to the aqidah, inshallah. last week we discussed the hadith which was reported or narrated by Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, when he said on the day of Khaybar, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded Abu Talha to make an announcement. So he called out saying, Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prohibit you from eating the flesh of domestic donkeys, for it is considered as rijs. And we already explained the meaning of the hadith last week. So today, inshallah, we'll go on some of the benefit that we derived from this hadith. There are many benefits, okay, or many lessons that we need to learn. First of all, we mentioned that why did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam ask Abu Talha to make the announcement, and he did it by himself? If he did it by himself, this will be more stronger. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speak, it's not if somebody else talk or speak or gave the announcement. Here, because we said, because Abu Talha was, mashallah, he has very, very strong, loud voice. Right? And the Sheikh derived from this a lesson that it is for the Muslim to use whatever available means to transmit the da'wah and the rules that Allah Azza wa Jal revealed. So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam at his time, there is no microphone, technology that we have these days. So he chose this Sahabi radiallahu an, because he was well known of his strong, loud voice, and asked him to make this announcement, so the message will reach as many people as possible. You see? So this is the first thing. And from this, we learn that the tools, or using the tools, or the equipment, or anything which is in technology, it's not bid'ah. You know, because some people, as we said last week, they would say, there is no microphone at the time of the Prophet ﷺ. Why do you use microphone? Huh? There is no this and this and this. This is ignorance. You see? But here, it's a matter when we talk about bid'ah, you know, remember the definition of the bid'ah. So if you know what bid'ah means, then you understand. Bid'ah is to worship Allah. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a way that he didn't describe to us. And use a microphone is not worship. It's just tools. But if somebody added in the salah, added in the adhkar, added in the way, right? This is considered what? Bid'ah. So anything, first of all, this should be an act of ibadah. Second, this ibadah that was done in a way different from the way of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this considered as bid'ah. طيب. So not many people now, anything is bid'ah. Everything is bid'ah. Anything they don't understand, they don't know, they don't like, they say, this is bid'ah. It's not, it was not at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is ignorant. طيب. Also he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ, Allah and His Messenger. طيب, why he didn't say Allah, then His Messenger? Because we know, if you talk, you cannot make the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam equal to Allah Azza wa Jal. And this is why, as you remember last week, we said, when a man, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ وَشِئْتْ, whatever Allah want, and you want. He said, wa, and. He said, did you make me equal to Allah? Say, مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَ. Say, whatever Allah want alone. Or, if you are talking, then you. It's very important. So sometimes some people, they said, Wallahi, lawla Allah wa ant. That's wrong. If it was not Allah and you, I will be in trouble. This is wrong. Why? Because we make and, wa. But this man saved you. So what should you say? Said, if it wasn't Allah, then you. Then that's mean you, Allah Azza wa Jal use you as a way to help me. So you truly help me, but without the help of Allah Azza wa Jal, without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you cannot help me. So you can't say Allah and you, but you say Allah then you. Allahu thumma anta. Allahu thumma anta. طيب, why here he said Allah and his messenger? Because here he is talking about what? About delivering message. And whatever Allah, the Prophet ﷺ is deliver, it is the message of Allah. So when he said, Inna Allah wa Rasulahu prohibit you, okay? Because Allah, the Prophet ﷺ by himself, he will not prohibit anything. So what he prohibited is what? The religion of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحِنْ يُوحَىٰ. So whatever the Prophet ﷺ command and say, it is what? It is revelation. It's command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is another benefit that we learn from this hadith. Like when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ فَقَدْ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَعَ اللَّهَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يُطِعْ الرَّسُولِ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهِ. Whoever obey the messenger, he obeyed Allah. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is delivering the message of Allah. He's not talking about himself. طيب? This is why the obedience of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is obedience for Allah Azza wa Jal. At the same time, whoever disobey the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that's mean he what? He disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, ومن فائدة إن الأصل في النهي التحريم. طيب, why it is haram? Why he said it is haram? We said that because he said it is rijs, it is unclean, it's impure, this type of meat, the domestic. And this, as we said, because you may read in some books and some justification by some scholars which say that Allah the Prophet ﷺ prohibited this because these domestic donkeys needed by people, therefore he stopped them from killing them, so the people, they are in need for them. We say this is not the right justification and not the right reason. And why? Because we mentioned that there are some other animals which always used and needed more than the donkey, and the Islam didn't make it haram and lawful. Like what?
Camel.
Like camels and cows, which is used more than domestic donkey. They are, you know, for farming, like the cows, for their milk, for their as a food, but it was not prohibited. طيب. Also, we learn from the hadith, the Prophet when talk about lahm, meat, here referred to the whole body of this animal. So nobody will come and say, yeah, the Prophet ﷺ said, ينهاكم عن أكل لحوم. He said meat, but he didn't say liver. So I will eat the liver of the donkey. He said no. Or the eyes, or, you know, no. So he talked about the meat, لحوم, then this include everything. So nothing. طيب? So we already explained this. I'm just making very quick. From this also, we learn that it is lawful to use or to eat or to consume the meat of the wild donkeys.
Zebra.
The zebra, okay? Wild donkeys. It is allowed. Why? Because he specified what? الحمر الأهلية domestic donkeys. That's mean other donkey is okay. If he said don't eat donkeys in general, that's mean will include all. But since he specified one type of this animal, okay, then it is only for this. طيب. We learn also, you know, the conclusion that we said last week, أَنَّ كُلَّ رِجْسٍ حَرَامٍ. Anything which is unclean, impure, considered as haram. But not everything which is haram is unclean. Sometimes something it is not lawful, but we cannot say it's impure or unclean. And we remember we talk about the wine, al-khamr. Al-khamr, haram. But by itself, okay, the liquid, you know, it's not, you know, there is difference between ulama. There are a difference between, some they said it is najis, and others they said no. And you remember we talked, the Sheikh said, by itself it's not. And he gave many justification for this. He said if it was unclean, then the Prophet ﷺ will not allow them to throw it in the street to the Muslim, because it's unclean. Also, he will command them to what? To clean or to wash the containers. While here, in this situation in Khaybar, when he commanded them to stop eating the meat of the donkeys, and they were at that time, they were cooking the meat because they were very hungry, they are far away, and they are seizing their enemies, so they are in need. So they were cooking this meat. So he told them to not to consume it. At the same time, he commanded them to throw it away and to clean their vessels to show that it is rich. So this is the difference between these two things. طيب. طيب. Also from this, from this, my dear brothers, we learn that if the Muslim learn about any ruling which he was ignorant about, then he have no excuse to continue. That means he should stop right away. For example, nowadays you will find some Muslim men, they don't know, they are wearing golden rings, right? He said, this is my marriage ring. And he doesn't know that it is haram, maybe. So if he was advised by somebody and told him, my dear brother, wearing golden rings is haram and lawful for Muslim male, he should what? What he should do? Huh? Should he wait till he go home? He should take it right away, because now he has no excuse. Before he was excused because he doesn't know. Now the minute that he knew, then he should take it away. Now take it off. He should not wear it. Not wait till you go home. Naam? So this is very, very important. You should not delay, you know, the response to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many, many situations. The Muslim, he doesn't know the rules. The minute that he knows the rules, then he should obey Allah Azza wa Jal. طيب. طيب, we'll go now to the next hadith. This hadith, it said, وعن عمرو بن خارجة رضي الله عنه قال خطبنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بمنى وهو على راحلته ولعابها يسيل على كتفي, أخرجه أحمد والترمذي وصححه. طيب, the translation of the hadith narrated عمرو بن خارجة, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, addressed us in Mina while riding his camel, and its saliva, its saliva was flowing onto my shoulder. Ahmad and the Tirmidhi related it and the later authentic. So it is authentic. طيب. Amr ibn Kharij is one of the Sahaba. There is not many more information about him, but he is one of the Sahaba of Al-Ansar. Inshallah, next week I'll try to get more information about this narrator. Wa alaykum as-salam. He said, Khatabana Khutba. Al-Khutba, you see, it's come in different meaning. But here means he addressed us in a religious ceremony, speech. The purpose of khutbah is to remind the believers about the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like khutbah al-jum'ah. Na'am, what's the purpose of khutbah al-jum'ah? Khutbah, that's mean, this was said khutbah, and the one who give it called what? Khatib. Khatib. Na'am, there's other type of khutbah. It's called khutbah. This is when a man have proposal to marry a woman. This is also called khutbah, but which is different. Here we're talking about khutbah when the Prophet ﷺ addressed the Sahaba to remind them about their religion or to give them instruction or to teach them about the deen. So, وَغَالِبًا مَا تَكُونُ بِمْفِعَالِ. The Sheikh said he tried to explain it. Khutbah, most of the time, it's mixed with the emotion. That means the speaker, when he speak and he give khutbah, he gives the instruction, the teaching, but at the same time he is what? Emotionally motivated. That you can see that maybe he raise his voice. Huh? Maybe that means he live the meanings and the concept that he's trying to teach the people. So he try to influence whoever is listening to him. طيب قال في مينا في مينا that's mean in Mina. And Mina, as you know, a place that we always go when we go to Hajj. It is a little town, just a little far from Mecca, and you know, side of it is in the Haram. Anyway, this Mina, so that's mean when you talk in Mina, that means during the time of Hajj, the Prophet ﷺ is not living there. The Sahaba is not there, or going for vacation of picnic. So it's in Mina because it was قال وكان ذلك يوم العيد. That means this was at the day of Eid. The Prophet ﷺ, when he go to in Hajj, he made one khutbah in Arafa and two khutbah in Mina. One at the day of Eid, okay, because the Eid, which is the 10th, in Mina. The 9th were in Arafa, and the other one is in the 12th of Dhul Hijjah. طيب. So, on this day, يوم العيد, when he was delivering the khutbah, to teach them how to throw to cast the jamarat. So he was teaching them the ritual of Hajj. What should they do? And in that day, people, they come and ask him many questions. You know, and he said, if'al wala haraj. Do it and there's no harm. Some people, they said, I throw before I shapes, others they said, I shape before I throw. And whatever they asked him, they said, if'al wala haraj, to make it easy for people. So this is the khutbah that was mentioned here, the khutbah. And the other one was in the 12th, to teach them about the way that to leave, to end or to conclude their hajj. That means he's giving instruction and teaching to those who want to leave early, after they finish their ritual. طيب. The khutbah, as the Sheikh said here, of the khutbah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are of two types. What does it mean here? That means there is regular khutbah, It's called khutbatun ratiba. Khutbatun ratiba. That's mean regular. Always. Like for al-jum'ah. Friday khutbah. So given every Friday. This called khutbah ratiba. Right. Khutbatun aridah. That's mean it depends on the occasion. Naam, occasion. The Prophet ﷺ saw something wrong, or some people they come, complain. So he will stand and he will give ceremony or give khutbah. This khutbah is not scheduled before, and it's not on a regular basis. This is called khutbatun aridah. طيب. طيب. The Sheikh brought the question about khutbat yawm arafa, because some people are confused. Yawm arafa, the Prophet ﷺ, he gave khutbah, but the question, because it was also Friday, it was Friday. Prophet ﷺ, when he made Hajj, it was Friday. Yeah, that means the 9th of the Hijjah, it was Friday. So now there are some people, they said, yeah, the khutbah that he gave because it is Jum'ah. Others, they said, no, this is khutbah special for Arafah, for Hajj. طيب, which one is correct? That it's not Jum'ah. How did we know? First of all, because this done in every Hajj, even it was not Jum'ah. Right or not? Second, that he gave only one khutbah. And he didn't give two khutbah. Third, after the khutbah, they started the salah. طيب, started the salah, and he combined dhuhr and asr. Combined dhuhr and asr. And we know that it is not permitted to combine al-asr with you in the day of Jum'ah. So it should be dhuhr. So it should be noon prayer and not Jum'ah prayer. So the salah the Prophet ﷺ, he did in Arafah was not Jum'ah, was not Friday, but it was what? It is because of day of Arafah. طيب. طيب. Here the point is, وَلِعَابُهَا يَسِيلُ عَلَىٰ كَتْفِي. The salvia of what? Of the camel, because he was holding the camel for the Prophet ﷺ. The Prophet was sitting and giving instruction, teaching the people. And you know the camel, and these animals, sometimes their salvia go out, dropping. So it was dropping on the shoulder of the Sahabi. The Prophet didn't tell him you should clean this. So he approved it. That means the salvia of the camel is not najis. It's not najis. That means it is clean. And anything which we allow to eat its meat of animals, whatever come of it is clean and pure. طيب, except the blood. So for example, you hold the sheep, and the sheep, it's come, the salvia of the sheep is come in your hand or in a clothes, you can go ahead and pray, no problem, it's clean. Naam? Anything which come from these animals is clean. Why? Because it is allowed for us to consume it, to use it. And here we go back to about the donkeys, the domestic donkey. The Prophet ﷺ said, it is, this the donkey is rijis, najis. طيب. Then does the salvia of this donkey, طيب, and the sweater that's come out of it, clean or not clean? It should be not clean. This is the general rule, it's not clean. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ said, it is rijis. But it is considered as clean, huh? Not because of other reason. What if it? Same rule that we apply on cats. You know, the cat, we don't eat cat. It's not lawful to eat cats, right or not? And the cat, when it's drink from your vessels, you can continue and take wudu. And said, how come? Subhanallah. He said, this is the cat is not lawful to be eating. It's not lawful. And then it's drink from this water, and then you make wudu from this water. But you said to us that anything which is unlawful for us or rijs, then it's not clean. How can we understand the situation?
The cat is not najis. Everything that is unlawful is not najis, right?
Naam?
The cat is not najis.
No, not because of this here. The reason why, because it was explained in other hadith, إِنَّهُ مِنَ الطَّوَّافُونَ عَلَيْكُمْ. The cats, because it's always around. You know, you cannot, you know, stay away of it. So if the, and the Sharia, Islam, made it easy for us, not difficult for us. See, it is, but here, because it is around us, and it's hard to get away from it, then it is become allowed, as a matter of what, facilitating for us our life. You see, because from this reason also for the donkey, the domestic donkey, it is rijs, right or not? It is rijs because of the hadith said innaha rijs, it is unclean, najis. And then the sheikh said, but the salvia or whatever, you know, if you are wearing in the domestic donkey and it was very hot and they're sweating from the and touch your clothes, this is not consider as unclean. He said, why? He said, because of the same reason. Because people are using this and it's hard to stay away from this. If anybody who will, whenever he ride the donkey, will go and wash his clothes and took shower, it's become what? Difficult for the people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it easy for this reason. مِنَ الطَّوَّافُونَ, same as the rule which was applied in the cat. طيب. Naam? Yeah, because we need to... How much time will it?
35 minutes.
35 minutes?
35.
Okay. We just finished this fawaid. Then one of the fawaid that it is okay to give khutbah while you are riding a camel. Like for example, for these days. If the leader of the group or the sheikh or the imam, he stand up on the top of the bus, and talk to the people. He said, no, you should not go down. How come you give khutbah or you give from the top of the bus? He said, this is okay. Okay, why? Because here, an example of her. So it's okay in this situation. Right. Also here, we understand, we learn some of the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wait. طيب. So we'll move to درس العقيدة. طيب. طيب we start درس العقيدة. We have 20 minutes. Yeah. طيب بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. إن شاء الله next time, إن شاء الله next week will there is only one or two of the فوائد, will finish it إن شاء الله. طيب we already have been in the first chapter of this book. We talk and